We were just having a ball. It's the most fun I've ever had, I think, making a record. I don't know if you're supposed to have fun making a record, but it was fun. I'm more ready to rock now than I ever was in my 20s. I start out with a riff, but as far as the story, it's almost like it's like a little ride or something. You hop in and you hold on and you're kind of writing your way through this wilderness. I've just been, the last 3 years, I've just been kind of messing around, you know, with family and friends and guitars. It's always the same old story for me. You really just want something to sing. And you just tend to draw, I tend to draw from whatever's going on, you know, around me.
It is a hurting thing, you don't want to talk about it. Pain in your heart, well, it's taking your breath away. You left it in lipstick on the mirror, no use talking about it. Love like this just don't come along every day. Somebody just stop calling you angel. Somebody just stop calling.
Well, now it was 1990. We did bring the family. We did Slow Turning. Stone Moments was kind of, you know, I was kind of the end of something in terms of writing. What I was writing about, I was sort of wrapping some things up. I think it kind of finished a piece of work or something, you know, with those three little platters. Playing with the individuals of Little Village, it was quite an experience, you know, for all of us. Totally, I was slammed and juiced by this band. They just sent me flying musically. I got re-energized by the whole experience. Golly, playing with these old guys, you know, in Little Village, me being the youngest, I felt like it was time to cut loose a little bit. I didn't want to make another record where they draw from the same talent pool that I was already connected with. So at one point we were talking to Matt Wallace, and then we were talking to Andy Wallace. And at one point we were maybe going to work with him, and then maybe work with Matt, and then we were even toying with, you know, the Wallace thing kind of came up, and we thought, well, maybe Mike Wallace from 60 Minutes, you know, could produce it. Or George Wallace. We wanted to get a Wallace. This is probably the closest to what I thought I was cooking up when I wrote the songs from probably any album I've ever made. It's like all of a sudden, it's okay. The three chords that I know are back in vogue. Well, I can tell you this about Something Wild. It was recorded originally by one Mr. James Osterberg, AKA Iggy Pop. I don't have any reservations about other people, you know, having success with my songs rather than myself, you know. To have a guy like Bob Dylan cut a song. People like Aaron Neville, Bonnie, I've always admired her work. And so these, you know, inspirational people, and to have them cut your songs, it's like, it's kind of unbelievable when you sit back and think about it. You know, hindsight's always 20/20. There's nothing like doing a new album, which we've just done, and then look back at the one prior to it, and you're always more enamored with the one you just completed, you know. This stuff kind of was, it's a lot less personal stuff, but it's, in a lot of ways, I think maybe it has more emotional sort of impact to it.
Trying to shave. Well, I guess old habits are hard.
reasons it's kind of hard for me to talk about my songs is because, well, first off, oftentimes I don't know what the hell I'm on about when I write the damn things anyway. But also, I like this idea that people interpret things, you know, in their own way.
1963, his mama wouldn't buy him that new red harmony. He settled for a sunburst with a crack, but he's still trying to break his mama's back. Oh, it breaks my heart to see those stars smashing a perfectly good guitar. I don't know who they think they are, smashing a perfectly good guitar.
If I could characterize this record in one word or less, I would say, I would think the word would be juicy. That's all I'm going to say about it.